I am so very pleased to announce that Tom Benson and Gail are going to be the next owners of the New Orleans Hornets as soon as we can finish board approval process, about which we expect no problem. Tom's history of success in sports is well known, and his fact that he was born and raised in New Orleans and done such a spectacular job with the Saints made him, in my view, the ideal owner for the NBA franchise in New Orleans. Tom has been a leader. He's deeply invested in the rebuilding of New Orleans post-Katrina through Champion Square, Benson Tower, buying the local Fox affiliate when others would buy it from out of town, and donating millions of dollars to Louisiana charities over the years. I know he will incorporate the Hornets into a huge and proactive symmetry downtown near the arena so that New Orleans will have a, is it New Orleans? New Orleans will have sports and family entertainment downtown year round, and that's going to be spectacular from the NBA's perspective. I know that Tom is a firm believer in investing in New Orleans. He's made huge, huge commitments, and our goal all along has been to get the Hornets bought by somebody whose commitment to New Orleans would be unrivaled and who added so much additional value as the owner of the Saints does. We have been extraordinarily well supported by the people of New Orleans and the people of Louisiana. We have been extraordinarily supported by Mayor Landrieu and Governor Jindal. I do want to acknowledge the great job that Jack Sperling and Hugh Weber and the entire staff have been doing to keep the home fires burning in the hope that we would get to this point, because we've been embraced by New Orleans through difficult times. The city is one of the country's treasures, and we really have found the perfect owner. So, Tom, welcome to the NBA.
All right.
You're only
right.
One player away. Tom, well, you want to say a few words?
Well, you know, first of all, that as the commissioner mentioned, I was born and raised in New Orleans. Went to Texas and made a few dollars, and it looked like the Saints were going to have to leave New Orleans. The owner that was up for sale, there wasn't anybody to buy it. And so I ended up buying a football team. And that, and certainly it's been very, very successful, and it's been a good thing for New Orleans, and this is what's going to happen with this club. We expect this club to be one of the most outstanding clubs in the league. Otherwise, I don't want to get involved with it. That's going to be our, right off the bat, our goal is to win the championships, and our goal is going to be that this thing's going to be great for New Orleans. We need this. My wife Gail knows we maybe don't have we got about 10 hours a day left, so we got to do something with it, and that we got to. So we really interested in this. We're going to make a great club. I mentioned that to the owners today, this afternoon, that we're going to give them a lot of competition. So with that, it's going to be good not only for us, it'll be good for the league too, you know, and I think that in doing that, you're going to see some outstanding basketball, something that all of us can be proud of, the commission and everybody else. And, you know, when clubs do well, all the rest of the clubs enjoy that as well, too. So that's the way we feel about it, and I think that this is just a good thing. And I'm glad to be part of it. And you all got a great commissioner here. Boy, I'm telling you, he knows how to put it on you, you know.
We were working very hard together to get rid of present ownership. Questions?
Jimmy, you want to start there on the left?
Tom, you've got
you've got a lot going on with your football team right now, including negotiating a contract with your franchise quarterback. How does this affect at all what you're trying to accomplish there?
That's a good question, because I talked to Drew Brees this morning personally, and I told him what was going on. He was very excited about it. He's due in next week, and we close. You know, just you know how those things work, and it just takes a little bit more time, a little patience. And we got a few other things that's going on right now with a draft and players, and that's keeping us real busy. But we haven't forgotten about him. We work on it every day. As I told you, I talked to him personally this morning. He felt very good about us getting involved with this club and with the Hornets, and that I think that'll be done shortly.
And to David, Tom was in this process initially when you started to solicit bids. He walked away and came back. Did you ask him to come back into the bidding process? And if so, why did you think that was an important part of it?
Well, I think that to have the leading sports owner in the state and one of the leading sports owners in the country involved in the process speaks for itself. And I figured if I could get the big guy involved, I could raise the price. And then get him to pay it, okay? And so it worked. And I can say that now that the check has cleared. There were many prospective people who were interested. And at the end of the day, I think because Tom recognized what he could do for the team, what the team could do for the city, and other, I'd say, joint business opportunities for entertainment and further development, that he was the natural purchaser, and we gave him the opportunity to do that.
Just a reminder, a name and affiliation, please. Richard in the middle.
Yeah, Richard Sandman from the New York Times. Tom, can you talk about how you will integrate both the teams and how you do business? Will somebody, an advertiser buying sponsorship from the Saints, be required to buy something with the Hornets, things like that?
Well, let's start with the sponsorships. There's certainly there's a lot of duplication of sponsorships right now. And you got a small community, whether it's a bank or one that's good as the Ochsner Foundation, they're pretty big in our area, and they sponsoring the Hornets right now, and they're a sponsor of the Saints as well. So I don't look for any problem there, and that matter of fact, we think there's some things out there that we can reach out even further into that sponsorship area, you know, and that we won't have any conflict. I got to tell you, besides Dennis Larcher here and my wife and Stanley Rosenberg, our people, our vice president of marketing, our vice president of ticket sales, and the key people in our organization are very excited. I'm talking about the Saints right now, are very excited about this. They think that, and the reports, since some of this has already leaked out, is out there, reports that we're getting from New Orleans and the phone calls that I'm getting is just so positive. It's just really great, just really great.
And we have a very good group of professionals at the Hornets now that are looking forward. I'm in the process of telling them that Tom has 77,000 seats accounted for through season tickets, and he's going to help deliver a sellout every game. He wanted a challenge because he's only got 8 regular season games in the NFL, and you really have to work exhibitions. No, you really
two preseason and yeah, two playoff games.
I understand, yeah, but the playoff games are easy. The preseason you make them take anyway with the regular stuff. So we got 41 plus exhibition and playoffs. So we really have to work in the NBA. So we're gonna introduce Tom to a whole new way. It's called retail, but wow, we given the combined capacity of the two organizations when it finally gets worked out. After the approval, it's going to be extraordinary and necessary. It's a small town, and having the kind of connectivity to it Our Jack Sperling, who was born and bred there, has been doing a great job. Tom and his folks work very well with Jack, and we're looking forward to a seamless transition and one and one equaling about four.
Jimmy, name and affiliation?
David Jimmy Smith, New Orleans Times-Picayune.
You when, again?
Yes. We go back a way.
Yeah.
When is the Board of Governors approval expected, and why hasn't it been done at this point?
You mean because we signed the contract yesterday? There are forms to be filled, investigations to be done, financial forms to be done, a whole, you know the lawyers, how they slow this down.
Yeah, but he's got my money, though.
Well, it's only a small down payment. I would hope that, it would be done as quickly as possible. It just can't be done overnight. And Tom wouldn't want to join any league that would have an approval process that did it overnight.
Any further questions, Mr. Benson? If not, go ahead, Scott, in the back. Take one more.
Scott Soschnick with Bloomberg. Tom, would you have bought the Hornets if you didn't own the Saints? Without that synergy, does it make sense?
Wait, what was that now?
Would you have bought the Hornets if you did not own the Saints? Does the synergy that we've spoken about make sense?
Yeah, many years ago when I lived in San Antonio mainly, we brought the Spurs to town, and I was a minority interest in it because my interest was getting a basketball team in the city. And Hornets are so important in New Orleans, I would support them without the ownership of the Saints. I think they are tremendously, not only New Orleans, the whole state and the whole southern area there. If you'd have been on the phone with the governor this morning, I thought he was coming through to kiss me. And that, but it's very, very important part of our community.
We've emphasized in the course of these discussions with the governor and the mayor that the Hornets are perhaps the best representative of the ability to say New Orleans is really open for business, because those 82 games that are played involve 217 countries and 47 different countries and territories and 47 different languages. So in combination with the Saints, it's a real statement about the vitality of New Orleans and the state of Louisiana.
Going to take the last question from Mr. Benson. Richard?
David, can you say how much the team has lost since you, since the NBA has owned the team?
I could say it.
Well, would you please say it?
I would say we funded losses last year, is what I'll say. This year, the team is a break-even proposition.
Okay. He added that to the price, by the way.
Yeah, we did, and he assumed it. Okay. Yeah, you're in the ballpark, but it was in fact, as Tom said, as we constructed the purchase prices and include making us whole, and so we feel pretty good. We weren't in it to make a profit. We wanted to hold it together for the perfect purchaser, and we got him. We got them, Tom and Gail. Thank you very much.
All right, Mr. Benson, you can
excuse me. Get out of here before
David
it gets hot.
Goodbye.
By the way, I wanted to speak my wife, though. Gail, she's been a very important part of this. She really has.
Thank you, Gail.